Morning, Kaufman. Today is April 4th, 2018. My name's Nick.
And I'm Kylie, and you're watching Kaufman Live.
Kylie, weather is gross.
The weather is gross.
How do you feel about the weather?
You know, I'm not a fan. That's why I'm wearing short sleeves today, because I'm ready for the warm weather.
You are more than prepared for it to just lighten up outside, for it to be blue skies.
Sick and tired of this cold stuff.
It's horrible. It's terrible. We start today by recognizing that this is the 50th anniversary of the assassination of Martin Luther King Jr. On April 4th, 1968, King was gunned down outside a motel in Memphis, Tennessee. CNN 10 returns to the site of this pivotal moment in America.
This is unbelievable. You look up there, it says Mason Temple. This is where Martin Luther King, 50 years ago, gave his incredible mountaintop speech.
I just want to do God's will. And he's allowed me to go up to the mountain. And I've looked over, and I've seen the promised land. I may not get there with you, but I want you to know tonight that we as a people will get to the promised land.
That night, April 3rd, 1968, King checked in here, the Lorraine Motel.
He gets dressed around 5:45, and he steps outside off the balcony of room 306, and he speaks to other guests that are in the courtyard. At approximately 6:01, a fatal shot rings out. Dr. King lies mortally wounded on the balcony. He's taken from the balcony to St. Joseph's Hospital, and he's pronounced dead at 7:05 p.m.
Shocked and saddened by the brutal slaying tonight of Dr. Martin Luther King, I ask every citizen to reject the blind violence that has struck Dr. King, who lived by nonviolence.
I am tired. I am weak.
To me, it's like a returning to something rudimentary and fundamental. I mean, this is where Martin Luther King breathed his last breath.
The owner of the Lorraine Motel decided not to recheck this room out in Dr. King's honor and memory.
This is exactly how it was left?
It was left this way, isn't it?
Right there when it all happened, King's partner and dear friend, Reverend Ralph Abernathy, his wife Juanita, on this pilgrimage 50 years later.
The night that Martin Luther King Jr. was assassinated, you were with his widow.
Yeah.
Tell me about that.
I told Coretta, I said, well, I'll meet you at your house. And I stayed there that night with her.
Is it true that, did you sleep with her in her bed to comfort her?
That's right.
The night that her husband was
killed? The night that he died. I slept on his side of the bed. And my little children were there with her children.
Amazing grace, how
tell me how you're feeling. I was watching you standing
well,
here.
Well, you know, it's very emotional to come here. Papa was not here that evening. He changed my life. He inspired me to stand up, to speak up, and to never give up. And when he died, I think something died in all of us.
Communications Club has a meeting today after school. We will be making posters for the upcoming Film Fest. Stay tuned for more details about our Film Fest. Seniors and juniors in the college search process are invited to visit Day at Columbus State this Friday at the Columbus campus and Tuesday, April 24th at the Delaware campus. Explore Columbus State's majors and student services, plus transfer options to four-year partner universities. You'll discover how starting at Columbus State lets you earn the bachelor's degree you want from the university you choose and save $30,000 or more off your total college cost. Go to cscc.edu/visitday to reserve your space today.
Physics Club will meet next Monday after school in room A208 to watch a video all about the space-time continuum of our universe. NHS has a mandatory emergency meeting before school tomorrow at 7:20. We cannot overstate the importance of this meeting, as we will be discussing the due date of senior hours, the canceled lock-in, and electing junior officers. A no-show will result in immediate ejection from the society and general shaming from the cult. Now over to Jeremiah with sports.
Girls lacrosse has been rescheduled to tonight against Thomas Worthington to tonight at home at 7. Also, track is rescheduled to tonight at Thomas Worthington. Tonight, boys tennis is in action tonight against Wellington tonight at home. Baseball is in action tonight against Hunter Davidson at home at 5. Now over to Kylie to talk about roses with Claire Taylor.
So Claire, what can you tell me about the NHS Rose Sale?
Well, we're selling roses all week this week, and you can send them to anyone, your friends, your significant other, and they go to a really good cause. It costs $3 for one rose and $5 for two roses.
Okay, perfect. Hope you guys get some good sales this week.
Me too.
Close it.
And once again, you just heard the news!